right.
Awesome.
Okay, we're glad you're all here. So this is a Bible story, and it's an interesting story. It's about children and parents. Do you have parents? Are you children?
Yeah.
Story's for you.
Yay.
And it's a very complicated story, so I'm going to have some help telling this story. So I want to introduce one of my friends here. This is Clara T. Muddles, a clown. And this is my other friend, and her name is Polka Doodle. And this is a
Who's
story
80?
About parents and children, so I need someone to be the daddy, so over here, Thomas is going to pretend he's the father of these two children. They're going to be the kids. All right? Now, sit here, Dad. His name is Isaac. This is a Bible story.
Isaac,
and I'm going to be Mud. My name's Rebecca, and I'm going to tell the story about my children. First of all, I didn't have any kids, and I was, like, getting old, and I really wanted kids, so I prayed to God, and God answered my prayer. Times two, I got twins. But even before they were born, my children were wrestling inside of me. It was like they were fighting even before they were born. Ouch! And then when they were born, the first one to come out was all red. So he was called Esau, which means red in Hebrew. But close on his heel was the other one. So I named him Heel. Grasping his heel. This Jacob, that's heel for Jacob in Hebrew. So we've got red and heel, my two sons. Very, very different, even growing up. Red here, he liked to be outdoors, he liked to hunt, he just was almost never at home. And he was his daddy's favorite. Isaac loved Esau. Isaac loved the meat that Esau would get from the hunt, cook up and give to him. Heel over here, Jacob loved his mommy. And mommy loved Jacob, because Jacob was good around the house. Jacob would help me cook and clean and just take care of everything. Oh boy, I love Jacob. Well, one day, parents were running around, and Jacob and Esau, well actually Jacob was making food. And Esau came running in from the hunt, and he was really hungry, and he saw that food that Jacob made. He said, "Give me some of that food." And Jacob said, "What will you give me?" Have you ever done that? You know, your brother or sister would say, "What are you going to give me?" And Esau said, "I don't know. What do you want?" And Jacob said, "Well, you're the firstborn. That means you've got the birthright. Give me your birthright." And Isaac said, "Whoa. Well, you know, I'm going to die anyway, so what use is my birthright? If you don't give me some food, I'll die. So here, have my birthright. Give me that food." It wasn't even meat, it was lentil stew. So, okay. Then, later on, they kept fighting and wrestling and having arguments, and then their daddy got really old. And he called Esau over to him and said, "Esau, I'm getting old, and I can't see too well, and I don't know when I'm going to die, so I want to make sure I give you my blessing before I die. So before the blessing, go out and hunt me some game, and then make my favorite dish with that game, and come back, and I will give you my blessing." So Esau went off to go hunting. Get some. Now, I heard Daddy promise Esau the blessing, and you know I like this one the best, and I want Jacob to have the blessing, so I said to Jacob, "Look, your brother's going to get the blessing, but I'm going to make sure you get it. So go get some goats and kill them and cook them up. And we'll make your father's favorite dish. And then you go in there and get the blessing." And Jacob said, "Well, he's going to know I'm not Esau because Esau's all hairy and red." And I said, "I can fix that. Just take some of the goat skin and put it right here. And then he'll know because he can't see too good. He'll just feel that you're his son." And then Jacob said, "Well, I don't smell like meat, you know?" And I said, "That's okay. I'll just put some grease on you and some Esau's clothes. You're good to go. So take the food and go in and get your father's blessing." So Jacob did. Andy when I said, "Father, bless me, I brought you my your favorite food." And Isaac said, "Well, you know, the voice is Jacob's. Are you sure you're Esau?" And yeah, I'm Esau. I really, 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 truly am Esau. Feel me. So Isaac felt how furry he was and said, "Let me smell you." Jacob, the firstborn blessing, the best blessing you could ever have. He said, "Your brother and all your people in my household are going to kneel down to you. You're going to be number one because you got my blessing." So Jacob said, "Yes," and ran away. Because just then, Esau came in from the hunt with his dish that his father liked and went into the tent and said, "Dad, just what you asked for. I'm here to get your blessing." And Isaac said, "Uh-oh. Who are you?" I said, "Well, I'm Esau. Smell me. Feel me. I'm your son." And Jacob said, "Your brother cheated. He got here first and took your blessing." And Esau was so sad, he wept. He said, "Please, please give me a blessing. Please, please." And Father said, "Well, you can only really give one firstborn blessing, but you should have this blessing. It's really not as good." So Esau was going really sad and really, really angry. So obviously Esau was probably going to shoot his brother. So I said, "Look, David, you need to go. You need to go really far away. Go stay with your Uncle Lot," which he did. Now, 20 years later, Jacob wanted to come home, and he had all these children. So you can be the children. So Jacob, here's your children. He wanted to come back, but he stayed put. You're now Jacob's children, and he had wives and children. He was rich, and he wanted to go home, so he sent messengers to his brother Esau and said, "I'm coming back. I'm going to send you all these presents so you'll forgive me." And the messenger said, "Well, we took the presents to Esau, but he's coming, and he's got 400 armed men. He's coming with an army to meet him." And Jacob was pretty scared about that. So he kept his children on this side, and then he went over here, way apart, and he went to sleep by a river. You're safe, because he's going to meet Esau first. So he was sleeping, and it was night, and a man came and wrestled with him all night long. They wrestled, and they wrestled, and they were evenly matched, and nobody could win, and it was almost daytime. So the man cheated and pulled out his hip, and Jacob had a limp. But Jacob kept grasping onto this person and said, "Let me go." And said, "I'm not going to let you go unless you give me a blessing." Because Jacob thought blessings are a good thing. So he said, "I want a blessing from you because you might be God's angel." No. So he said, "Okay, but first I'm going to give you a new name. I'm going to call you Israel, which means you wrestle with God and people all the time. And here's your blessing." And then he let him go. And the man went away, or the angel, whatever it was, and Jacob limped away. Till the morning, and Esau came to meet him. And Jacob was still scared because, Esau had all this. So he ran towards Esau. He was bowing. He was like, "I'm really sorry, Please forgive me." And Esau came. And guess what Esau did? He ran to meet him, and he didn't kill him. They wept, and they hugged. And Esau met all Jacob's children. Yes. And that is the story of Jacob and Esau. Now, these clowns don't know it, but after we do the children's time, we usually say the Lord's Prayer. And there's a line in the Lord's Prayer: "Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us." Did anybody forgive anybody in this story?
Yes.
Who forgave you?
Esau
forgave Jacob. So they were answering Jesus' prayer way back before Jesus was even born. So let's hold hands and say the Lord's Prayer together. kind of sewing? You can just watch. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us